Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss the chapter of linear programming problems. It's a quite easy chapter and it is something with a lot of practical application. So normally we will be wondering where mathematics is used in real life. So this is one such chapter where we will feel that it is made full use or fully applied. So let us have a look where these things are applied. In each problem when we are facing here, we will come through situations in industries, in research, in medicine, in factories, in business or in commercial field, etc. We will find there will be discussions about profit, loss, percentage of errors, there may be raw materials used, or there may be the end product which has to be discussed in particular units, and what will be the profits and or gains or losses which can be minimized or maximized. We'll be discussing about those things in this chapter. So let us get ready to look into some basic concepts that we'll be studying in this chapter. First let us go to some basic definitions. So first of all, problems which seek to maximize or minimize about profit or cost form a general class of problems called optimization problems. So what is an optimization problem? See, in real life, whenever we do business or different any kind of transaction, we'll be always looking at what is the profit or loss that's going to happen to us, what will be the estimated cost for the object or the goods or the end products. So at that time we will try to assess or try to estimate what will happen to our end product. So these problems will be looking at the maximum loss or minimum loss or maximum profit or minimum profit. Such things will be dealing in this. So some problems which deal with such extreme values, either the highest or the lowest value, such problems are called as optimization problems. And to come into the second point, that is, in among optimization problems, linear programming problems are a certain kind of problems which use linear equations to solve the problem. So we will be concentrating only on these which contain some linear inequalities and equations involved in this solutions. Third one is a definition of optimal value. See, linear programming problem is one that is concerned with finding the optimal value, which is either maximum or minimum value of next definition, that is the fourth one. What is a linear, this linear function z is equal to ax plus y by that you see there, that is exact, actually it's called as an objective function. That first one what you're seeing, z equal to ax plus by, we recognize it as a linear equation, ax plus by, but we have always talked about ax plus by equation always with a constant c. You might remember it as ax plus by is equal to c, but here we are not equating it to some constant, we are equating it to a function of x and y together, and we name it as z. Normally for other chapters you have been looking at functions like y is equal to f of x. Here z is equal to function of x comma y. So we have a function which contains two variables this time, and that function in this case is z, and we call it as objective function, which for which we will have to find out the maximized or minimized value, the optimal values which we discussed about. We will be looking at this function. So this is called as objective functions, and those variables x and y will be called as decision variables because they decide the maximized and minimum values of the objective function. Coming to the next point, fifth point, another definition we look at. So here we are talking about what are constraints. See, in regular life we have a lot of constraints. When you're driving down the road, you have to keep left here, and so if you are in the college or school, you need to not use mobile phones. That is a constraint put upon you. You have to wear uniforms for your job. That is a constraint or a restriction put on you. So these are restrictions in real life. Similarly, we have restrictions put on these equations whenever we come across real life situations of products and the raw materials used, etc. There may be certain constraints on us, some restrictions put. So such restrictions will be there found in this chapters on these equations also. Those inequalities or equations or restrictions that is given to the variables will be called as constraints. Example just in front of you, that is there, the conditions x greater than or equal to 0 and y greater than or equal to 0 are called non-negative restrictions, or you can call it as non-negative constraints. Most of the problems here will contain this non-negative constraint. This constraint will be commonly given for all the problems, and even if they are not mentioned, we will assume them as x greater than or equal to 0 and y greater than or equal to 0 as a standing instruction given to us as a constraints. Continuing that, some other definitions here. So when we further proceed in this chapter, we will see that there are two methods. One of the method is simplistic method, which we will not be following for this syllabus. What is there in our syllabus is called as graphical method, which is kind of a little more easier. The other one is simple but a bit of confusing type. This is more pictures skew and you can understand this idea easily. So we will be using graphical method, that is there for our syllabus. And in this graph that you draw, most of you might have already seen these type of graphs in last year, the previous year when you studied inequality, chapter of inequalities, you have gone through some graphs. So these graphs are very similar to that. So look at the sixth point, what it says. The graph of this system means the shaded region that will you will get in the problem. It consists of the points common to all half planes determined by the inequalities. What does this mean? This means, see, an equation when you solve, you will get a straight line. An inequality is not the points on the straight line, but either it will be on one side, either side of the line. Either it will be lesser or greater. If it is lesser, those points will lie on one side of the line. If it's greater, it will those points will lie on the other side. So the points will either lie in inequality, you have found lesser than and greater than. So the points will lie any one side of the line. So if a plane is bisected by a straight line, you will have two halves of the planes. So that is what we are looking at here when we say the points are common to all half planes. The half plane means one side of the straight line that you get. So when you draw an equation on the graph, in the graph when you draw a straight line and compare an inequality with that line, automatically you are getting all the points on one side of the line. So here, let's continue. Each point in this region represents a feasible choice, means that is a possible choice. Whatever point you come across in that region on one side of the line, that will give you some choice which is very, very practically possible. And all that points together will form the region on one side of the line. And we call that region as a feasible region for that given problem. So every point of this region is also called as feasible solution. So all the practically possible points that is there on one side of the line, we will call them as feasible solutions, and the total region will be called as feasible region. Coming to the next point, seventh one. Any point in the feasible region that gives the optimal value of that is the maximum value or minimum value, the extremes what we are talking about. So it is the extreme values of the objective function, when you see that, is called as the optimal solution. So we saw that objective function that is called as z is equal to ax plus by, right? And suppose we solve a problem and we get two extreme solution, like on one side we have an answer of 10 and on another side we have an answer of 10,000. So which is the maximum here? Clearly 10,000 is the maximum and 10 becomes the minimum. These both values will be called as the optimal values, and the preferred solution, what you get there, is called as the optimal solution.
Continuing from there, we have two theorems on linear programming. I would be summarizing both of them together. We don't have the proofs of these theorem for our studies here. It is not included in our syllabus this time. We need to only concentrate on the statements and accept them as axioms. The way we accept axioms without any discussion, we just accept these two theorems. Combine both of them together gives an idea of if you get the feasible region, let us call it as R in this case. So the feasible region or the bounded region that you get, in that feasible region, the objective function z, which is equal to ax plus by, will have its optimal values, please concentrate here, at only at the vertices or the corner points. See, whenever we chart these graphs, we find that the graphs are mainly polygons, either the simplest one being the triangle or any quadrilateral we may get. And in case we have too many constraints or too many inequalities, we may get higher polygons also, like pentagon or hexagon is possible. But let us go for simple ones like the triangle or a quadrilateral. In that case, the vertices of these triangles and quadrilaterals, what we find, that vertices are also called as corner points in this case. And the optimal values, the maximum and minimum values, according to the theorem, will lie at the vertex. So each vertex or corner point will give us an idea of an optimal value, and we have to compare among these values which is the maximum and which is the minimum. So but it is clearly mentioned in the second theorem in bold that the R is bounded. Now there arises a question. So what in case of unbounded regions? See, there are cases in some of the problems we will find unbounded region also, but we will discuss those cases as and when we deal with the problems. Right now we just need to remember that in case if the region is bounded, then the polygons vertices are nothing but corner points, are called as the positions where we find the optimal values, either the maximum or minimum. So let us get on with the problems.